child would not be at the beginning interested because it's complicated. I see that it's paying off. So I'm so proud that, like, I don't need to be putting a lot of effort in him, at least going forward. Fortunately, I had a sort of like a best teacher, I would say. So that's one of the reasons why that he was able to catch up.
Great hero for any child is their parents. Today, I'll be having a conversation with a father who is identifying and nurturing his child, a sign of good parenting, I must say. Mr. Mohammed Ilyas, who is a chartered accountant working in Qatar, is constantly in search of adding value to his son, Zayed. Mohammed Ilyas understands the importance of education and learning, helping Zayed pick skills at an appropriate age and creating a path of a better future. Welcome, Mr. Mohammed Ilyas. I would like to begin asking you to understand, why did you choose QDPA and how did you go about choosing QDPA?
It was all because of COVID, actually. It was almost at the early stage of COVID where I was looking for him to be homeschooling. There I was looking for something which could add value for him. So it could be of anything. I wasn't targeting, to be honest with you, specifically coding or robotics. I was looking for something that is, which is out of the school curriculum and also should be adding some sort of value to him. I find out this one through a YouTube video that I was searching for. And then I got in contact with a course coordinator. Somehow I managed to convince them to have him on board. Since he is sort of like a young guy, so initial impression from them was sort of like, probably like a sort of like a fear that he might not be able to catch with the content. But however, I managed to convince them and somehow made him on board with the course just to see if he could catch up with the things that are being taught for this subject and for this module. And in fact, actually, it worked out. This is how I started off with QTPI.
Yeah, so I understand, like, okay, when you started, like, in a year and a half ago, I think he was like five and a half years old, if I understand.
Yeah.
And a lot of parents have inhibition of thinking of coding for children. You see a lot of, there is an kind of thinking like, no, childs are too early to learn coding. And many of them would probably go for various other activities. Why did you choose something like this when they could have an activity like art and drawing and craft work?
To be honest with you, there is no specific reason why I chose this, because I chose something that was sort of like randomly, just wanted to give it a try, something which is out of the school curriculum. I just wanted him to be challenged because he is learning under British curriculum, which is sort of like not challenging. I find it like not sort of like strong enough for a growing child to be challenged in many aspects. This is why I wanted something like, but I wanted something which is out of the school curriculum. At the beginning of COVID, I found it like the coding was sort of like becoming so popular on Facebook, WhatsApp, and YouTube. So I find it like, yes, we could give it a try on this and just see like how that he could be challenged. And then it worked out. Then I found it like, yes, he is too interested in. Blessing in disguise, I would say.
Yeah, no, wonderful, because I see some kind of a sign which you see in your child. So do you foresee that Zayed is keen in learning something which is very challenging than what he's learning otherwise in school?
I found it from the school curriculum one thing, that he is an early reader. By the way, by the age of 4, 4:30, he was able to read confidently. Most of the time, he was able to understand the content as well. Like, it's not only about the reading, but also about the content. So which was sort of like an advantage for him at the beginning, so that he could start off with something new. Because at the end of the day, for example, even if he is to go through coding or if he is to go through something, because at the end of the day, there are written sentences, right? At an early age, what we did was, like, by the age of 3 or let's say 3, even 2.5, we started pushing him to have a sort of like to develop his reading skills. Which was something, just then we noticed that as long as he has the right reading skills and understanding at least partially of the content, like let's say 2 years back, that we thought of like he should be able to grab the subjects on his own. So I always focus on self-development because I don't want to be sitting around him every now and then because we are so busy. I want him to be learning as much as he can on his own. This is the whole focus that I have. But initially, like, you know, because it's not only the coding class that he attends, but also he has maths class, he has English classes. Most of them are online, where almost for about, let's say, 9 months that I was sitting with him literally on every class. I just wanted to make sure that he grabs this. So I wanted to be sitting with him. And thereafter, I gradually started. But the whole focus was at that time. So I just wanted him to be a self-learner. This is the whole objective of this. In case that he needs something, that I would be teaching him. Otherwise, he should be able to learn on his own. I also have some passions and skills where I would like to concentrate on my own.
I understand that you have a lot of keen and interest in his overall development and self-development of the child, and he understands your path, what you put in for him. But how is he reciprocating to what you're asking? And does he show a reception towards what you want him to do?
No, not every time, yes, by the way, because he's sort of like a guy, he needs a lot of attention at the beginning. But as soon as he catches a topic, which is something that which he will remember forever. So this is how that he works. So initially, always he needs supports, probably like beyond a normal child. This is what I see in him. For example, in terms of maths, he does not easily catch up with the subject unless he has the right understanding. Like until that time, he will say like he will have issues. I know that he will be struggling. This is I experienced with mathematics at the beginning, where even he would not do an addition or like a subtraction unless he understands almost everything. Like, for example, let's say when I say like 5 plus 5, then he would say 10, but he has doubt, like saying, okay, what if somebody would ask from me 15 plus 12, then how should I do it? He will ask that question. So unless that part is sorted out, then he will not go for this part as well. Because initially when started seeing the numbers from 0 to 100, then he would ask, what if I go with more than 100? What if there is an issue that is 500 or 1000? He will just randomly choose the number. So he has issues in his mind. He has thousands of issues which he needs answers. I always have hard time at the beginning just to make him convinced. Now, for example, let's say he could learn numbers. He could read, I'm just giving an example. He could read numbers up to 6 trillion, meaning like, for example, billion, million, 6 trillion, 1000 trillion, like any number which you thrown at, he will be able to tell it. Because that's because he always asks the questions like, for example, if I would teach him up to 100, he would say, what if I go above 100? Like, what do you call it? Like, so this is a pain for me at the beginning, actually. Like, it has been a pain throughout, actually. He always asks questions which is not being taught at that time, then he always asks. So unless the next question is answered, then he would not feel comfortable about the one that he's learning. Like, now I'm teaching science, which is of grade 3, just because of him only. Because he was supposed to learn grade 1, so he has thousands of issues and he is asking thousands of questions. Because he would not understand the grade 1 science unless he knows that there is an issue which he, like, for example, let's say the other day that I was teaching him about the life cycle of an animal. Then he would ask like, okay, what is the life cycle of a computer? Like, okay, so like, okay, is there any life cycle? So like, okay, so why there is no life cycle for that? Like, it has got a beginning, then it has got an end. So why don't you call it like life cycle? So like, this is a confusion that he has. So then I would say the life cycle is meant for living things. Okay, then you said the water cycle. So what is that water cycle? Like, you know, like, so this is the issue that he has. When he would struggle with, for example, let's say a coding subject, I know why that he is understanding. Unfortunately, sometimes that he is not able to express that, like, he has another questions which he doesn't know sometimes how to ask. So that
I see it having a curiosity of a child's learning process, and every child has this amazing curiosity to ask questions.
Yeah.
I also would like to understand, as a parent, you went ahead of an investing for a child at a very early age in terms of learning process online, and you happen to buy a robotic kit for a child.
Yeah.
What is your first reaction on seeing the kit, and how did you find the sessions post the having the kit?
Fortunately, I had a sort of like a best teacher, I would say. So that's one of the reasons why that he was able to catch up with the content, I would say, because it was a content, something that which I believe probably like a child who is of like 5.5 might not be able to cash, because you know that that's an issue and plus sort of like a challenge, to be honest with you, actually. But somehow he managed to get him over. Now, I feel like he is pretty comfortable, because it's not only about the robotic content, I would say. Like, at the end of the day, that he should be able to read and understand, because there are so many words, there are so many technical contents which he should be able to understand.
So what I understand you saying, one is a good product which is required, and you also need a good right mentor or a teacher to make
it. Yeah, of course. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay. That's a good product. There is no issue on that. And along with that, a good mentor is also required. Yeah.
So then you'll see an equilibrium happening because of these two things. Otherwise, it's
yeah, yeah, yeah. Balance. Yeah, yeah. Yes. Yeah.
And I also see, as a parent, you have been a very positive bringing changes to your child to upskilling through coding and robotics.
Yes.
What are the positive changes do you see because of his learning for the past 1 year plus?
I would say that because of coding, like, first of all, to be honest with you, just before started his coding, he wasn't able even to switch on the laptop, by the way. He doesn't know anything about computer because we never taught him at that point of time. But on his own, I don't know, somehow he came up with an idea. Now he is comfortable with the keyboard and he works on his own. Even when I'm away, he doesn't need any support from me or anybody to be working with the laptop.
So yeah, I understand he knows the literacy of computer now.
What he's supposed to learn, and he has learned throughout this coding. That's one aspect. The other aspect I've seen in maths, where he's progressing super fast. It's a sort of like a building blocks, right? Sort of like addition, multiplication, basic these operations. So once somebody masters this, I would say like it's almost like sort of like analyzing. I've seen him so much of progress in maths. Now he's doing grade 3 maths and he's doing mental maths. So he can do addition, multiplication on his own. Plus, I've seen his progress in English as well. The only issue that I find with him is that he's not that expressive. But although he's very expressive at home, actually, I don't know, like, he's very talkative. But in front of people, that he still has that sort of like hesitation talking. And maybe I believe it is compensated by other subjects like mathematics, coding. So I see that, you know, not everybody can have everything right. So.
Yeah, so what I understand is you're saying analytical skills and logical thinking of him, the curiosity.
Which has grown up tremendously, yes.
Yeah, yeah. And I understand that there is an area which you feel that like a social emotional skills or socialization, which probably will happen once the schools resume and then he interacts more with the peers. I think he's going to surely pick it up and he's going to be able to talk to even strangers. I must appreciate you in participating in kids' learning. And I've also heard from the coach who takes the session that you would generally have a quick conversation post some of this session with the Jay.
Yeah.
I also see this as a very good parenting tip for anybody parent would like to know how to know whether child is progressing and what child is learning.
Yeah.
Why did he choose this process, or it became accidentally or intentionally he had planned it, or what was that your thinking behind having this conversation after every session?
That's because when a subject is sort of like a bit challenging, just wanted to make sure that if there is an area where that he can be taught at home and where he needed support from, so that I could be taking up with him. So once every session is over, just wanted to make sure that if he has any issues with regards to a particular area, so just wanted to make sure that he is taught. Because my approach for like in calculating the knowledge is pretty simple. Like, as soon as the subject is done, I want to make sure that in case that he has issues with, then he would be taught on the same day or the next day, that throughout the week that he'll be free. This is the approach that I have. That's the approach that I'm always following with anybody, like, so that it makes my life easier also, so that I could be concentrating on other stuff.
Yeah, on a lighter note, I would say this is a skill which most of the good chartered accountant have it, or accountant have it, which they make sure that things are right and they are completed for the day activities.
Yeah, sort of like, I would say, yeah.
Yeah,
it's always, you know, hanging at the back, right? It's always there in our mind.
Numbers, okay, yeah. Trouble. Yeah, numbers can trouble and can bring troubles in the future also.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's wonderful to see that you're adding skill and nurturing Zayed at a very early age. I think it is good rather than numbering, saying early or not early. And I also see that you're very well informed in terms of a parent taking decision in helping him to introduce various activities for him to see overall development.
Yeah.
Which generally a lot of parents would say, no, let them play, let them not do things like this.
Yeah.
While there also, yeah, there also been plenty of debates happening around, which I see on various social media. The parents' opinions are very differing about it. Not sure what they have experimented also, at least. That they say that the 6 year is too young to code or to do robotics or learn AI and so on. What are your thoughts on the same?
I would say, the way that Zaid struggled at the beginning, like for any subjects or in coding, I would say if Zaid could learn it, anybody could learn it. Because I know the pain that I was going through with him, especially at the early age. It was so worse. Like, I would say not only about the coding, like even at the age of 3, he wasn't able to catch up with most of the things that was being even taught at the school. Then I had to sit with him and I had to work around him. I had to work with him. Then he was able to catch up in no time because it's a sort of like a customized approach. So yeah. I would say if Zaid could be taught, and I would say definitely any child could be taught as long as there is a sort of like a support from the parent, because of course the child would not be at the beginning interested because it's complicated and it's confusing, right? Because they don't know, because for example, Zaid, he didn't know anything about laptop or computer, anything about this. Even before starting off with the coding, that he was supposed to have a sort of like a familiarity with the technology, at least the laptop or the computer. If it would be confusing, they wouldn't be starting with like, okay, although it looks fancy, but I'm finding it confusing, difficult. So I would say that it's all about parents, by the way, actually, until the age of 7, 8, 9, it would be. And the other thing I see is that from young age, we should always focus on, like, from age 3, the self-learning. Like, they should be able to learn. We have to provide the context. We have to provide or set up the right environment where they should be able to learn on their own. Although they're children, I do understand that they need a lot of help, but it should come from them, not the parents, that who would decide what to be done, what to be taught. But let it come from him. Let's provide, for example, let's say, the context, and let them get into it, let them get into complications, let them get into confusions, and let them come out of it. That's how I work with myself. Maybe because of the busy schedule that I have, which I'm not aware of, but I always want him to learn on his own, because I know that I would not be able to sit around him with even going forward. So that's my approach. Like, maybe for any parent, I would say, although they are children, you should find a way to make them learn on their own. Set up the technology, give them room, give them books, let them struggle, let them go through the pain, and then let them come out of it. I don't want to be like sitting around 24/7 chasing them. No, give the content, give the technology. Sometimes some of my friends say, no, he gets addicted to laptops. And I would say, not now, even going forward, that they're going to get addicted too. But why don't you guide them and do something which is useful? Of course, some people would say, it harms the eyesight and all these things. But I don't believe in those theories much. Like, okay, but there are people who have been using laptops and computers for years and years and years, and they have no issues with the eyesight. Maybe I find it like this is sort of like a misconception. And the only thing is, and this is how the future is going to be. So let them learn it. So let them spend 2 hours, 3 hours with whatever, but we want to make sure that they do something which is useful. That's it.
Yeah, as rightly you said, I see a very interesting and a good parenting tip, which I would want to call it out. You would say that there will be struggle at early age or even at later age for a child to pick up and learn anything. And early the better, because the child will listen to the parent. As they grow older, they might not even listen to the parent, and it would be very difficult to put skills in child's development cycle. Is that right?
Yeah, so yeah, it is true.
What age do you think children should pick? Do we have some criteria like this, or you think the children should learn any the moment they are born?
To be honest with you, I see the surroundings where children are taught at an early age, like as low as 2.5 years old, 3 years old. Sometimes I see that as early as 1.5 years old. So I got the inspiration from seeing what's going around here. Although it might not be appropriate for everybody, but I see that some parents are giving it a try. I would say is that, yes, the children should be taught at an early age as much as we can. I would say there's no harm in giving it a try, because bombarding with thousands of information, let them be confused, because I don't see any harm, because they're not going to get mentally affected, because I don't see in him. Because let them be bombarded with whatever it is. So let them come out of it. Let them let them face the challenge at an early age. So, because that's the advantage I'm seeing him, by the way. You see, since he was challenged a bit earlier, now I find it like I don't need to teach him anything at the school. Like, he just goes to school, gets back, nothing is to be taught, because he knows, like, he says that, you know, these all are basics. I don't know where he has learned these words from. All what he's being taught at school is just basics. I don't get anything from him. So I get the teachers from also, like, he gets to the answers in no time. Although, like, I had to put an extra effort, maybe like 1.5 years ago. But now it's paying off. So I'm just concentrating on grade 3 studies. So now I know that it would be paying off much. In a way, putting an extra effort, like at an early age, is really paying off in terms of schools, in terms of other things. So I feel like it's the way forward. Like, they should be challenged with things that are beyond their levels. At, like, for example, at the age of 2.5, they could be taught subjects which could be 3.5 or 4. Like, so they are challenged. Of course, it would be very difficult at the beginning, but eventually they will grab it. Or at least they will grab some of the things which would be useful for that age. Yeah.
I definitely see an interesting thought process, because I also understand that younger the children, they have more time to spare and more time to learn. And as they grow higher, the time becomes a scale.
Yeah.
So I think you're wonderfully utilizing this time for child's development cycle and helping child acquire a lot of skills much earlier than required. So
yeah, but most of the parents, what I see around my surroundings, that they are a bit worried about bombarding with, you know, new sort of skills, new sort of things, because they're worried that they might not be able to catch them with, and they'll get more confused. Of course, they would get confused for a very short period of time. Like, okay, like maybe like 2-3 months. Of course, it's a pain. But as they get over, the outcome is, like, it's amazing. You wouldn't even believe that, like, how they would end up with. Now, like, for example, he is memorizing, you know, our books, the religious book, Quran. Like, you won't even believe that how far that he has memorized it. Like, so amazing. Like, we call it, like, probably, like, 15 or, let's say, 20 pages, maybe at a stretch of 2 months. So, I see that it's paying off. So, I'm so proud that, like, I don't need to be putting a lot of effort in him, at least going forward.
Wonderful. Thanks for your various inputs. I want to see a lot of good parenting tips which are given to us. You have brought a very new, different perspective towards the way you look at child's learning process. Mr. Mohammad Ilyas, thanks for your time. It was wonderful talking to you.
Yes.
And thanks for sharing your journey of helping.
Thank you so much for your time as well.